Aladdin Creations.
Hello guys, welcome to another video of Aladdin Creations. My name is Kavindu. Previously we have already discussed three malaria topics. What is malaria, malaria parasite life cycle, and how to diagnose malaria in medical laboratory. So in this video I'm going to discuss with you our fourth malaria topic, how to identify and differentiate malaria parasites using thin blood smear examination. We'll discuss in this short video. We already know the gold standard malaria diagnosis test is the screening of thick and thin blood smears with Romanowski stain. Well-stained thin blood smear enable the differentiation easy for medical laboratory professionals. Some morphological characteristics of the infected red blood cells and parasites can be used to direct the diagnosis towards one of the four Plasmodium species that infect humans, which are Plasmodium vivax, Plasmodium falciparum, Plasmodium ovale, and Plasmodium malariae. Well, each type of malaria display a unique set of characteristics in infected red blood cells that can be seen under a microscope. Let's take a closer look at how to identify each of the four main type of malaria. Ring stages. Ring stages of all Plasmodium species except Plasmodium falciparum show large chromatin dot. Plasmodium falciparum on the contrary has 1 to 2 small chromatin dots. Also we can see some chromatin dots are on the surface of the red blood cells. This is known as applicative forms. The high proportion of infected red blood cells can be seen here, including double parasitic cells, is characteristic of Plasmodium falciparum. The large cytoplasm with occasional pseudopod is seen in vivax ring stage. Remember, Plasmodium vivax selectively infect reticulocytes. Therefore, we would expect to see a low-grade parasitemia with ring trochocyte in the larger red blood cells. A stony cytoplasm is seen in ovale and malaria ring stages. Also, Plasmodium ovale likes to infect young red blood cells which are bigger than other red blood cells. Therefore, ring stage seen inside large reticulocytes are characteristic of Plasmodium ovale infection. Red blood cells infected with Plasmodium ovale will reveal the cell's edges are feathered. Trochocytes. Trochocytes of Plasmodium falciparum are rarely seen in peripheral blood. When available, they are seen with compact cytoplasm with dark pigments. Presence of multiple trochocytes in one cell is unique to this species. Trochocytes of both Plasmodium ovale and malariae are compact with a large network of chromatin. The difference between two species is that Plasmodium ovale trochocytes have dark brown pigmentation. These scrofulous dots will distort the parasitic red blood cells into an oval and giving Plasmodium ovale into its distinctive nameshake shape. In Plasmodium vivax, large amoeboid cytoplasm, large chromatin and fine yellowish brown pigmentation can be seen within red blood cells. But unlike Plasmodium ovale infections, these scrofulous dots seen in Plasmodium vivax don't distort the red blood cell shape. It actually stays more rounded without feathered edge. While Plasmodium malaria trochocyte large chromatin can be occasionally seen in band form with coarse dark brown pigments, this feature is unique to Plasmodium malariae. Chichons. Chichons of Plasmodium vivax are large and they almost fill the entire red cells. 12 to 24 metrocytes are present in the chichon. Chichons of Plasmodium falciparum are rarely seen in peripheral blood. 8 to 24 small mirror-sized represent in the zygote. In mature plasmodium ovale and plasmodium malaria zygotes, 6 to 14 mirror-sized with large nuclei are present. Plasmodium malaria zygotes can rarely be present as rosettes. It means mirror-sized lined up around the perimeter of zygote with pigment in the center. Gametocyte. Plasmodium vivax gametocytes are round to oval in shape. They are compact and may almost fill red blood cells. The most distinctive finding of Plasmodium falciparum is the shape of the gametocyte. Unlike what we see in the other species of malaria, they are crescent shaped or banana shaped. Plasmodium ovale gametocytes are round to oval in shape, compact and may almost fill red blood cells. They are larger than normal red blood cells and have a granular appearance as well as scrofular dots. Plasmodium malaria gametocytes are round to oval in shape, compact and may almost fill red blood cells. In all four species, chromatin dot is compact and eccentric in macrogametocyte and diffuse in microgametocyte. Chromatin in a single mass can be seen in Plasmodium falciparum macrogametocyte. Size of red blood cells. Red blood cells infected with Plasmodium vivax are enlarged to approximately 1.5 times the size of normal red blood cells. Also, red blood cells infected with Plasmodium ovale are larger compared to the normal red blood cell. Red blood cells infected with Plasmodium falciparum are normal in size, and red blood cells infected with Plasmodium malaria normal or smaller in size. Scrofular dots. Scrofular dots are fine invaginations at the surface of the infected reticulocyte. These are present in red blood cells infected with Plasmodium vivax and Plasmodium ovale. Well friends, I hope you guys enjoyed this video and gained knowledge about how to identify and differentiate these malaria parasites using thin blood dyspnea examination. In my next video, I hope to design as a quiz video to increase your these malaria parasite blood stages identification skills. So guys, don't forget to subscribe my YouTube channel and hit bell icon to update with more medical laboratory science and medical related videos like this. Thank you.